Attention, everyone. At this time, we ask that you please take your seats. Also, please silence all cell phones for the duration of the ceremony, which starts in a few minutes. Thank you.
To purchase a brick so that we had something to show our connection forever.
I think it's a great way to memorialize your time as a Capital student and a great way to support the university as an alumni.
I went online and ordered a brick to be placed on the plaza in his memory.
Ross and I met at Capital as student ambassadors. We were friends all through Capital, and then after Capital, I invited him as my date to an event that I was the event planner for. He was very impressed because he sent me flowers afterwards. From then on, we started dating, and now we've been married for 3 years, and we just had our first baby, Hildy, and she is 3 months old. All of our beginnings and now our current life are all connected to Capital, and we truly love this community, and it's still such a special place to us.
When I look back on my time at Capital, I think some of my favorite memories are when I was in my fraternity, Phi Kappa Psi, and on my brick I have my Greek letters because the community of FSL at Capital was so important to me. Most of my best friends and greatest mentors came from the Greek community at Capital.
My husband, Nicholas Perini, was a professor at Capital. He started in 1958, stepped down in 2011, so he was at Capital for 53 years, which, to my knowledge, is perhaps the longest of anyone that has been at Capital. He loved Capital. He loved teaching. When he gave lessons at home, I was around the corner and heard, and it always amazed me what he knew to bring out of his students. But when Nick passed away a couple years ago, I wanted to honor his memory in some way because there were so many students that loved him. And I also thought his 53 years deserved some recognition. I think it's just a wonderful way to commemorate so many wonderful things that have happened at Capital through the years.
I think that's a really important part of being an active alumni, is staying engaged, whether it be donating funds or time. There's always an opportunity to give back to your alma mater.
We get to roll our daughter in the stroller past a brick that we purchased at the university where we first met and where Ross asked me to spend the rest of my life with him. So it's something that is literally a foundation in our relationship and our lives. So it's the beginning of telling Hildy exactly how we met and reminding her of that every time we're on campus.
Family and friends, welcome to the 172nd commencement of Capital University. Please rise for the presentation of the American flag by the ROTC Color Guard. Today's The Symphonic Winds will be conducted by Associate Professor Tony Zielinczyk. Please be seated for the processional. Thank you. The invocation will be given by the Reverend Drew Tucker, University Pastor. Please stand for the invocation and remain standing for the national anthem.
I'm Drew Tucker, Capital's University Pastor, and I am honored to gather with you graduates. Congratulations on your achievements. Let's join together in a time of prayer to acknowledge the sacredness of this space and the value of this moment in your lives. We begin by acknowledging and honoring the Hopewell, Miami, Adena, and Shawnee nations upon whose ancestral homelands we gather this morning, as well as our indigenous siblings who continue to care for this place, this land, and call it home. May their love for creation offer us a hope for building a shared community where all can thrive. And so we pray a blessing upon this assembly, and especially upon these graduates. Rooted in their traditions, growing from their education, may they blossom into the beauty that others bring. Send these holy people on a sacred journey with sacred purpose wherever you call them. Bless now our celebration with your holy presence, and send your breath of life with us always. Amen.
Please be seated. Members of the Capital University Chapel Choir, led by Dr. Linda Hassler, will now perform two selections. The first selection is I Will Sing. The second is a Chapel Choir traditional selection, The Lord Bless You and Keep You.
As we see fit for a while.
Dr. Hassler would like to invite any choir alumni in the audience to come forward now and join the choir for "The Lord Bless You and Keep You." Everyone, please welcome the 17th president of Capital University, David L. Kaufman.
Thank you, Dr. Hassler, and thank you, choir. That's got to be one of the best traditions anywhere. Well, good afternoon. Welcome, class of 2022. Hey? For those of you I've not met, I'm Dave Kaufman, and it's an honor to have the opportunity to serve as president of Capital University and participate in this celebration. So thank you for that. On behalf of the faculty and staff, I extend sincere congratulations to all of our students for achieving their degrees. Today, you take your well-deserved walk across the stage and receive official recognition for the graduation you worked so hard to earn. I'd also like to welcome family and friends who've joined us for this special day. We recognize and appreciate the impact each of you has made on the graduates we honor today. Thank you for your support and your encouragement. Graduates, your final 2 years at Capital were unlike any other. Out of necessity, you conquered the virtual realm of Zoom. Academically, you navigated between synchronous and asynchronous learning, presented group projects, and met with advisors virtually and in person. Socially, you held organizational meetings, shared your faith, and participated in student activities. And through it all, even the mass, we saw you shine. I agree with John Maxwell, an internationally recognized leadership expert, who said, "Change is inevitable. Growth is optional." During your time at Capital, I watched you. You chose to grow. The university also chose to evolve and grow. Despite the unique challenges, a Capital education remains distinctive for its commitment to excellence and its inspiration to live a life of reflection, leadership, and service. It's a place where students are accepted just as they are and become the best version of themselves. As a university, we welcome free inquiry, model ethical stewardship, and champion diversity, equity, and inclusion. As a Capital graduate, you understand these commitments and help create this special community that we cherish. Through interactions with others, your classmates, your roommates, professors, and staff, your Capital education has forever transformed you. And through your personal engagement and contribution, you have forever transformed this university. Today, we mark a new beginning and celebrate a milestone in your personal growth and achievement. Many of you will pursue your vocational calling. Others will continue academic pursuits in graduate school. A number of you will move far from Central Ohio. Some of you have chosen to explore international opportunities. Regardless of where life takes you tomorrow, today is a day to celebrate all you've achieved. As you move forward, take time to look back and reflect on the obstacles you overcame. Thank those who helped you overcome them and find a way to pay it forward. Forever a member of the Capital family, you are encouraged to keep in touch as you progress through your career and your life journey. The university is a trusted resource for your continued development, education, and guidance. Engage with us, share your story, and nurture the lifelong connections you made through your Capital experience. We are here for you, always, in all ways. Let your life be shaped by the values and commitments you developed here. You've learned that more important than what you do is who you are and what you value. Continue to ask, think, and lead as you progress through your career. You leave here empowered to contribute to causes bigger than yourself and make a lasting difference where you live, work, learn, and serve. And that's a difference that only you can make. It's a blessing and an honor to join you in this celebration as you enter the next chapter of your life and explore all the opportunities that will come your way. We are proud of you and celebrate who you are and all you've achieved. Congratulations. And now I'd like to introduce our special guests behind me on the stage. Starting on my far right is our faculty marshal, Professor Emeritus Dr. Lance Tibbles. Next to Dr. Tibbles is Reverend Drew Tucker, who gave the invocation. Then we have Deanna Wagner, our guest speaker. On my immediate left is Dr. Jody Fournier, Provost and Vice President of Learning. Next to Jody is Erica Clark Jones, class of 2012, and a member of the Board of Trustees. And then we have Dr. Sharon Croft, Professor of Communications. This year we did something different when it came to selecting our commencement speaker. Instead of choosing a speaker for them, we asked our graduates who from our faculty and staff they would like to hear from. We asked them to select someone who would be able to meaningfully share memories, insights, and words of wisdom across the last 4 years. And overwhelmingly, they chose someone who'd been alongside them through thick and thin, who offered wise counsel and treated them with respect, someone kind, someone authentic, someone who cared. That someone is Deanna Wagner, the Associate Provost and Dean of Engagement and Success. Please join me in welcoming Deanna as our 2022 commencement speaker.
Hey, friends. President Kaufman, Provost Fournier, Board of Trustees members, parents, families, guests of our graduates, and most importantly, class of 2022. I want to begin with thank you, because after today, when someone asks me for a fun fact, not that anyone around here would ever do that, I will forever tell people I have something in common with Kamala Harris, Condoleezza Rice, and Taylor Swift. Because after today, thanks to you, I'll be able to tell them we were all 2022 commencement speakers. Now I know you're thinking we've really got to up our game here. They weren't on our ballot. But I can promise you one thing none of them can promise their graduates: brevity. So jokes and Taylor Swift aside, it is truly the honor of my career to share this special time and space with you on this very important day. Can we all just take a big collective breath that we're here together, you've made it, and recognize what an accomplishment it is? Not only did you study a major or two, some of you three, start and lead student organizations, serve your community, lead teams during competition, work a job, two, three, or four, some of you, and perform on the biggest stages, but you persevered through a global pandemic. You navigated our switch to online learning in stride. You created innovative virtual opportunities to connect and be in community together. You led the country in this work. You wore masks when you didn't want to, participated in random testing even though it was uncomfortable, and continued to be flexible, learning to Zoom with wit, humor, and intelligence, sometimes without ever even getting out of bed. And you experienced loss. You missed out on big traditional events. You watched the institution and the world change before your eyes. You heard maybe next year, more times than you could count, wondering if next year was actually on the horizon. And most importantly, some of you lost people you love. People who would be here today, waving at you as you entered, cheering you on, or gathering around the TV for the live stream, anxious to hug you and celebrate you. I hope you can feel those people with you today, because they are. And I hope you know they are so very, very proud of you. One of my favorite TV shows, an oldie but a goodie, is The West Wing. And the series finale is titled Tomorrow. As outgoing President and First Lady Bartlett board Air Force One to take their trip home after the inauguration of the new administration, she leans over and asks him what he's thinking. He simply responds, tomorrow. Tomorrow. For years now, even in the midst of COVID, tomorrow has become predictable. Tomorrow was class, practice, student org meetings, eating in the MDR, complaining there was nothing to eat in the MDR and ordering Jimmy John's instead, gathering in the Bowman Center, going to work and internships, heading to the library late at night to socialize, maybe get some homework done, and then going to bed very late at night or early in the morning, depending on your perspective, and getting up and doing it all over again and again and again. But now, tomorrow may feel different. It may feel a little scary. Tomorrow may feel difficult. Tomorrow is full of the unknown, of packing up boxes and moving to a new chapter, perhaps in a new city with new people. Tomorrow is saying see you soon, because we do not say goodbye around here, but see you soon to people who have lived down the hall or across the street for years. But tomorrow is also exciting. It is another chance to be brave, to make a contribution to a community, to share in something new and unexpected. Tomorrow is a chance to find more lifelong friends. Tomorrow is all new and full of these opportunities. And as we head toward tomorrow, I want to share a story with you, one that I've shared with orientation leaders year after year, and one that is especially relevant today. There was a young woman who had been diagnosed with a terminal illness and had been given 3 months to live. As she was getting her things in order, she contacted her pastor to discuss her final wishes. At the end of their meeting about her arrangements, everything seemed to be in order, and the woman said, "There's just one more thing, and it's very, very important. I want to be buried with a fork in my right hand." The pastor stood looking at the young woman, not knowing quite what to say. He was puzzled. The young woman explained, "My grandmother once told me this story, and from that time on, I have always tried to pass along its message of love and encouragement. My grandmother said, in all of my years of attending socials and dinners, I always remember when the dishes of the main course were cleared, someone would inevitably lean over and say, 'Keep your fork.' It was my favorite part because I knew something better was coming. Velvety chocolate cake, deep dish apple pie, a very fancy cheesecake, something wonderful and very delicious. So I want people to see me there in that casket with a fork in my hand, and I want them to wonder what's with the fork. Then I want you to tell them this mantra that I have believed for myself all through my life and now even at my death, and for them. Keep your fork. The best is yet to come. So when you look down at your fork, any fork, but especially this fork that we're going to give you when you walk across the stage, I hope you will always remember the best is yet to come. The best is yet to come for Capital University. Capital is different because of you. Better because of your contributions. Better because you challenged policy and practice. Better because you have done hard things. Better because you are you and you were here. We are indebted to you for the time and talents you have shared with us. You have transformed Capital University. The best is yet to come for you. You will continue on your journey as game changers, challenging the status quo. You will be problem solvers who arrive at situations with solutions, not just complaints. You will continue to be the people who vow that no one will eat alone, and you will take care of each other from both far and near. You will show up ready to work, challenging the notion of this is how it's always been, and that's impossible. You will lead with empathy, intelligence, creativity, and humility. Capital University has transformed you, and you are more than prepared for this next step. Class of 2022, I speak for all of Capital University when I say, we could not be more proud of you, of all that you are and all that you are yet to become. We will always be here in your corner, cheering you on. Truly, the best is yet to come for you, and we cannot wait to see what you do with tomorrow. Thank you.
Please welcome Erica Clark Jones, class of 2012, and a member of Capital University Board of Trustees.
Thank you. As a Capital University Board of Trustees, it is my pleasure to now commission the awarding of degrees. I ask President Kaufman and Provost Fournier to please come forward. President Kaufman, I invest in you the authority to confer degrees. Provost Fournier will now present the candidates.
Will the candidates for the bachelor's degree please rise and remain standing? President Kaufman, on behalf of the faculty of the college, it is my privilege to present the candidates for the degrees of Bachelor of Arts, Bachelor of Music, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, and Bachelor of Social Work.
Upon the recommendation of the faculty and by the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees, I now confer upon each of you the recommended bachelor's degree with all the rights and privileges, as well as all obligations and responsibilities. Congratulations, graduates of class 2022.
The candidates will be introduced by Sharon Croft, Professor of Communication, and Jennifer Adams, Director of the Center of Global Education. They will be assisted by Dr. Terry Lam, Senior Associate Provost. Candidates for bachelor's degrees will receive their diplomas from Dr. Fournier and President Kaufman. Dr. Fournier and President Kaufman will now greet the graduates and present their diplomas.
Caitlin Renee Ellison. Emily Grace Johnson. Caleb A. Long. Kiera Baxter. Timothy Elijah Kanky. Karen Lynn Kanky, magna cum laude. Kelly Jean Wright Lovell, cum laude. Alexandra Rose Kerr, summa cum laude. Abigail Marie Bebau, summa cum laude. Ayana Akua Trammell, magna cum laude. Scott David Hurler, Jr. Cassidy Nicole Drabick, cum laude. Allison Marie Cruitt, summa cum laude. Megan Elizabeth Shoemaker. Jonna Elaine Simmons. Nathan Gray Blake, summa cum laude. Hannah Marie Tan. Casey Elizabeth Honecker. Amelia Wilhelmina Ruggles, summa cum laude. Elisa C. Patton. Brandon Madden, magna cum laude. Kokila Varadarajan. Ayana Nicole Lewis. Patricia Hanna. Noah Gebremariam. Kasim Sindai Haruka. Olivia Fisher, cum laude. Caitlin Rebecca Dobbins, summa cum laude. Katrina Lee Davis. Lina Michelle Freeman. Christopher Ryan Hale. Ashley Wireman, magna cum laude. Jackson Nixon, summa cum laude. Jordan Ileana Willis, magna cum laude. Elena M. Foos, magna cum laude. Jalen Rianne Branch, cum laude. Jordan Elizabeth Banks, cum laude. Sydney Jordan Jones Lawson, summa cum laude. Sheila M. Doda. Joseph D. Capozio, summa cum laude. Evan Wesley Barr, cum laude. Nolan Hunter McClung, cum laude. Ethan David Sheck, summa cum laude. Morgan A. Wiley, cum laude. Francesca L. Baber, magna cum laude. Megan Elizabeth Hall. Ryan N. Mitchell. Amelia Laura Dillman, summa cum laude. Macy Ann Mills, summa cum laude. Nathan J. Reaney, magna cum laude. Caroline Hannah Cramblett, magna cum laude. Grace H. Day, summa cum laude. Sophia Marie Bucci. Kayla Catherine Falutko, summa cum laude. Kelsey R. Kitchell, summa cum laude. Olivia Ann Rafferty, magna cum laude. Jessica Nicole Weaver, cum laude. Sarah Grace Hall. Robin Emily Tershak, magna cum laude. Hannah Joy Koger, magna cum laude. Megan Woodruff. Tyler S. Miracle, cum laude. William Quarter Cooley. Austin T. Copley. Jordan Elizabeth Mader, summa cum laude. Lauren Grace Harris. Emily Catherine Paymer, magna cum laude. Zachary Michael Oler. Chelsea Joan Grisby, cum laude. Hannah Elise Cronin, summa cum laude. Alisa Lee Watson, summa cum laude. Madeline Marie Pace Chismer. Matthew Jeffrey Longfellow, summa cum laude. His diploma is presented by his mother, Joy Longfellow, class of 85, and adjunct professor of mathematics. Nathaniel William Mulby, summa cum laude. Denny Mabata. Miranda Lee Jordan, magna cum laude. Maria Jane Pickerel, cum laude. Joshua R. Conturo, cum laude. Marshall K. Evans, summa cum laude. Olivia L. Fuelgraf. Riley G. Young. Kurt Maxwell, summa cum laude. Brendan James Stinson, cum laude. Tyler James Knapp. Bryant Caparelli, magna cum laude. Brandon Lee Barnett. Kaylee J. Prawl, summa cum laude. Ella J. Brickman, magna cum laude. Elizabeth Grace Christian, cum laude. Madeline Lee Hopkins, magna cum laude. Taylor Elizabeth Adams, summa cum laude. Barry Warfield, cum laude. Caitlin Grace Reed, summa cum laude. Daniel William McPherson, summa cum laude. Skylar Cheyenne Mag, magna cum laude. Mackenzie Lange, magna cum laude. Kayla Nicole Null, summa cum laude. Autumn May Grant, magna cum laude. Ariana K. Thatch. Alexis Simone Collier. Haley J. Grau, cum laude. Callie Ann Moskal. Madrine Herdlich. Vanessa M. Sharp, magna cum laude. Grace Colleen Humphrey, cum laude. Emily Kamichek, summa cum laude. Daniel Allen Messersmith, summa cum laude. Paris Day Knapp. Sarah Nicole Walsh, cum laude. Danielle E. Toma, summa cum laude. Lexi Marie Anderson, magna cum laude. Marin M. Taylor, summa cum laude. Meredith J. Reed, summa cum laude. Megan Victoria Miller, cum laude, summa cum laude. Brianna Lynn Vance, summa cum laude. Alexa Elizabeth Odom. Victoria Elizabeth Wymond, magna cum laude. Carlin Nicole Perez, magna cum laude. Tyler Newhoff. Allison Kimberly Ellis. Kaylee Michelle Noaker, summa cum laude. Allie N. Rogers, summa cum laude. Madison K. Shiner, cum laude. Jack Henry Shepherd. Randy J. Newgester. Christian L. Wilschbach. Isabel Paige Hysong, cum laude.
Kimberly Nicole Rega, summa cum laude. Maria Sue Keller. Allison Lynn Songier. Shelby Faye Bethel. Clinton J. Kitchen. Michael Smith. Kylie N. Long, cum laude. Sierra A. Massey, magna cum laude. Sarah Michelle Rosado. Carolyn Marie Alexander. Caitlin A. Romero. Alicia Henton. Caroline Rose Lee Dravis. Molly Marjorie Wagner, cum laude. Oniquache Chelsea Ondiminyana, magna cum laude. Paris Jurakua Honga, cum laude. Grace Elizabeth Ackley.
Chloe Esposito, summa cum laude. Her diploma is presented by her mother, Laura Esposito, who is representing her late husband and Chloe's father, Dr. Steve Esposito, professor of communication.
Erin Elaine Llewellyn, cum laude. Caitlin J. Chavez, magna cum laude. Hillary Carol Counts. Alexis Nicole Van Kunkel. Kayla Alice Saley. Morgan Nicole Aiken, magna cum laude. Kaylee J. Stanijowska. Cole Baxter Williams. Olivia Janicki. Courtney Franklin. Gabrielle E. Heinley. Kendall S. Hunter. Lauren M. Chance. Gabriella Grace Schneit, summa cum laude. Kelsey Fox. Rachel Marie Geiger. Holly Elizabeth Barledge, summa cum laude. Emma Catherine Fain, summa cum laude. Gabrielle E. Viano, summa cum laude. Michaela Christine Tachi. Julia Suzanne Javis. Hannah Marie Moore. Megan Alexandra Mastachari. Olivia Rose Maxwell. Amelia H. Allen, magna cum laude. Joanna S. Toefold, cum laude. B. Keen. Mackenzie Dawn Lynham, cum laude. Madison Angeline Jones, magna cum laude. Reagan Elizabeth Morgan, cum laude. Bailey Renee Alsbach, magna cum laude. Cameron Eric Lee, summa cum laude. Joshua Alexander Onde. Nicholas Andrew Reber. Allison India Heppelman, cum laude. Tierra Whitney Mapp. Kendall Grace Farron, summa cum laude. Anna Marie Bobo. Emma Claire Stedrin. Chad William Davis, magna cum laude. Tyler Schreck, cum laude. Hannah M. Searles. Molly A. Searles, cum laude. Madeline Christine Rodenuff. Gabrielle Nicole Molinero, cum laude. Luciana Rose Kanowski. Julia Marie Desbolzo. Corey Nicole Barrett. Catherine May Myers. Peyton Reese Ritterbeck. Victoria Rose Cochran, magna cum laude. Jared Brett Warner. Tamara J. Reed. Kathleen Marie Brennan, summa cum laude. Grace Margaret Boyer. Delmato James Black. Cameron A. Hyde. Elena Chulney, summa cum laude. Hannah M. Clark. Jadalyn A. L. Buckley. Abriana Jade Damoff. Haley Marie Singleton, cum laude. Hannah Rose Singleton, cum laude. Okay. Elijah F. Danilitz, summa cum laude. Charles Reed Geddes, summa cum laude. Kevin W. Cuervo. Aiden Robert Wild Milton. Jacob Thomas Taylor, cum laude. Samuel Richard Spurk. Reese Simon Campbell, summa cum laude. Joseph Michael Escra II, cum laude. Bryce Grise, magnum cum laude. Devin Alexander Whipple, cum laude. Jessica Niniger. Bailey James Locke, magnum cum laude. Mitchell Jeremy Hughes, summa cum laude. Brooke Marie Longo Amaret, magna cum laude. Emma Marie Burns, magna cum laude. Dominic Rocco. Dylan Michael Wiseman. Blaine David Holbrook. Garrett E. DeBoard, summa cum laude. Aaron T. Starkey. Kristen Nicole Bryans, cum laude. Emily G. Tyler. Ailey Catherine Watson. Lauren Kelly O'Neill, cum laude. Leah Peters, cum laude. Riley Caitlin Herring. Brittany M. Wulugumi. Derek William Clear, cum laude. Christina F. Dowling, cum laude. Kirsten Alexandra Denlutz. Alina Z. Young. Sarah Bouye, summa cum laude. Kirby Shea Elizabeth Smith, cum laude. Stephanie Ann Ruse. Ashley Jordan Chilongo. Amanda Jean Sepien, cum laude. Emma Claire Hiltner, cum laude. Hannah Louise Hunt. Emily Elizabeth Sigler. Benjamin David Lauper. Abigail Renee Gruber. Miranda Freer, cum laude. Annalise C. Belt. Gabriel James Rook, summa cum laude. Jacob A. Crimians, magna cum laude. Dakota Kirkbride, summa cum laude. Brooke Elizabeth Shuttler. Madison Joe Austin. Bailey L. Dozer. Caitlin Ann Luther.
Please remain seated while we wait for the final graduates to return to their seats. Thank you.
It's now time to observe a commencement tradition for new alumni. Graduates, please rise. To signify your graduation, please move the tassel on your mortarboard from right to left. Also, graduates, let's recognize those who helped you reach this important milestone. Please turn and applaud your families, friends, and loved ones, and show your appreciation for their support. Now, for all who are able, please rise and join us for the singing of the Alma Mater. Please be seated. And now we observe one final important rite of passage. Graduates, you will recall your very first days on campus when our academic community was called together to welcome you as first-year students to Capital University. You celebrated with your family members as you processed through Memorial Gateway to begin your studies. But as you know, Capital's tradition prevented you from exiting the gate until graduation. Now we're going to complete this tradition by again calling our community together to applaud your success and your promise as you mark the completion of your academic journey by walking out Memorial Gateway. So following the benediction and recessional, we'll see you at the gate.
The benediction will be given by the Reverend Drew Tucker. Please stand.
Dear graduates, it is now time to bid you Godspeed and farewell. May you now leave this place transformed in order to transform the world for a common good. As you depart, even as you are called to ventures of which we cannot see the ending, by paths you've not yet trodden, through perils not known, may you find the faith to go out with good courage. May you trust that you are worthy of the path before you. May you know that though you don't know precisely where you go, that love always goes before you, leading and supporting you into this next great unknown. And wherever you go, and whatever you do, may you journey with beauty all the days of your life. Amen.
Please be seated for the academic recessional. A reminder for parents, family members, and guests, we ask you to make your way quickly to the memorial gate so that you will be ready to applaud the graduates as they exit through the gate. When the graduates exit out, please follow them. Exit out the doors at the back of the auditorium to quickly line the walkways leading to Memorial Gate and Main Street. Proceed under the Learning Center Bridge. Again, proceed under the Learning Center Bridge to the walkways leading toward the Blackmore Library. Directions are also printed in your program. So again, exit out the doors at the back of the auditorium to the walkways leading to Memorial Gate and Main Street. Proceed under the Learning Center Bridge to the walkways leading toward the Blackmore Library. Directions are also printed in your program. Congratulations to everyone, and thank you.